Okay, so for quiz number two, let's have our rationale. Hindi kayo mo net class. Wait lang. Let us wait para mag-open siya. Okay, so the first question. Calpol. This is a multiple choice. You have to, choose kung what type of drug is Calpol. So when you say Calpol class, that is a brand name of paracetamol. So paracetamol class is used as a functional modifier. Okay. So functional modifier siya kay it regulates the body temperature. Next, we have it determines the dose of the drug required to produce a specified magnitude of effect in a large number of individual patients or experimental animals. So you are looking here for the dose that will be effective for a large number of subjects. So pwede siya animal if it's a preclinical trial, and pwede siya sa tao, sa human. Pag clinical trial. So this is called, so tama na siya dyan, quantal dose effect. Okay, curve or curves. It's okay. Next, we have tubulin is an example of a regulatory protein. So ang atuang tubulin, remember, can be found during cell division. So it is a component of our mitotic spindle. It will, what do you call that? Separate the chromosomes into the opposite sides of the cell. So this is false because tubulin is not a regulatory protein. It's a structural protein. Okay, very good. Next, match the following subtypes of receptors. So when you say found inside the cell, so this is intracellular receptor, this is class 4. Okay? Tama, that is class 4. And then another thing, activation of the G proteins. So remember, the one that is linked sa G protein is the class 2 receptors. Once the drug bind to class 2 receptors, G proteins will take action. So it can be GIGS and GQ. Next, involvement of tyrosine kinase is class 3. Okay, very good. Because when you say class 3 enzymes, class 3 receptors, they are our receptors that is linked sa enzyme. And most of the time, it's tyrosine kinase. And then we have, syempre, GABA receptor is an example of a class 1 receptor. Ano siya? Ion-gated, meaning merong ion involved. When the drug binds to class 1 receptor, there will be an opening of the ion channels. Okay, next, partial agonist and full agonist can be taken concomitantly. Ang partial agonist daw o ang full agonist pwede sabayon o inom. This is false. Remember that the partial agonist will become an antagonist if you take them concomitantly. Okay? So that is false. Next, cefuroxime. Cefuroxime is an example or an antibiotic that is under the cephalosporins. So, kung antibiotic
siya, chemotherapeutic agent.
Chemotherapeutic agent. Next, Centrum is a brand name of multivitamins. So, pag multivitamins, replenisher na siya. Okay? Replenisher na siya. It will replenish, it will supplement what is lacking in our body. And then activation of our GABA receptors lead to the opening of, syempre, the chloride channel, or you can just write CL. So, nganong wala gidawat ang chlorine. Plus, remember sa chemistry, chlorine atom, it is uncharged. So, that's the difference. Atom, chlorine atom. Now, if you say ion, so naana na siya yung charge, we call it chloride. Chloride. Cl negative, okay, later. I-remind ko, Belly, kay i-recheck na to siya. It's okay also if you write the negative charge. Wala na ko siya gibutang mangod sa answer because I cannot write the negative na naa siya sa taas. Okay? Next, paclitaxel. I guess I have mentioned this drug sa inyo, ha? The paclitaxel.
Chemotherapeutic.
Okay, chemotherapeutic. So do not forget, class, that paclitaxel is an example of an anti-neoplastic drug or anti-cancer drug. Yan, si Mama Besigig chat. Kaya masulod siya sa akong klase later, alas tres. So medyo maano ato ang time sa break time. Kaya mag-observe daw si Mama Be. Mara siya sigig chat, alas tres, 3 to 6. Okay. Next, a receptor with an unknown ligand.
Orphan receptor.
Okay, you can write orphan or orphan receptor or orphan receptors. Next, a type of agonist that have an intrinsic activity less than zero. So, ang iyahang intrinsic activity less than zero. It reverses the activity of the receptors and exert the opposite pharmacological effect of agonist. We call this class inverse agonist.
Sad, ma'am.
Ano man? Yung malian
mo? Mali.
Mali, ma'am.
What's the answer ninyo?
Inana, ma'am.
Inverse. With S, ma'am.
Ah, with S. Wala ako pang ibutangan og S, man. Good. Daghan. Sige, it's okay. Kung ibutangan ninyo og S, let's recheck later. Next. Which of the following drug is the most potent?
Carvedilol.
The drug is potent, diba?
Carvedilol.
Looking at the dose, what's the answer here? It's carvedilol. So even if it's 600...
Nalipat po, ma'am.
Look at the unit. Ito?
Sa unit ko nalipat.
Okay. 625 microgram. Even if you convert that to milligram, it's still the smallest. Kasi if that is converted to milligram, it is equivalent to 0.625 milligram. Generous mo sa S. Okay. Munang gimalian ni Schoology. Next, what is the secondary messenger produced if adenylyl cyclase is activated consequently after GS protein activation? It's the CAMP. What's the meaning of CAMP?
Cyclic adenosine monophosphate.
Okay, so either of the two ang inyong answer, ha? Monophosphate.
Pwede man dahil kung CAMP lang, ma'am?
Yes, pwede pod CAMP.
Wala namin mamingkanggapin.
Adenosine
Gani. Monophosphate. Gani. Pwede yung mag-type ito, ma'am.
Ani dai ko dela, ma'am.
It's okay. Next, what type of antagonism occurs between histamine? Ganun na ulit ng question. Again, what is the type of antagonism? What type of antagonism occurs between histamine and epinephrine? So this is functional. Functional antagonism or functional functional lang pwede. Next, the drug that has a broad therapeutic index is considered toxic and unsafe. Pag broad kay dako na therapeutic index. This is false. I don't know if you can still remember the graph I made between paracetamol and digoxin. Remember, paracetamol has a broad therapeutic index and kasi malayo ang difference ng kanilang kanyang effective dose and the toxic dose. While lanoxin or digoxin has a narrow therapeutic index. So you can say that the drug is toxic and unsafe if it has narrow therapeutic index. Next, Tensilon. Tensilon is a brand name. So the generic name is edrophonium. So remember, we use this as a diagnostic agent to diagnose myasthenia gravis. Okay, the MG, myasthenia gravis. So that's an autoimmune disease involving the nerves that control our muscles. Next, the last one, a state of decreased responsiveness to the drug's effect as a consequence of continued drug administration. Continued, ha? Continued. So it is tolerance. Kapag ka rapidly after administration, kaisa pa lang ka ni administer sa drug, nawala na dayon ang iyahang effect or ang sensitivity sa receptor, we call it tachyphylaxis. Pero pag dugay sa kanang continuous pa na paggamit sa drug, ano na siya? Tolerance. Unsa immune? It's tolerance class, okay? So questions up, sorry. Kita ninyo score. Sorry. Nakalimot ko. Kumakita na yung score pag iano. Anyway, do you have ano clarifications? Kinsa ganito? Si Belly. Sige, let's talk about the autonomic nervous system. Class, sa pharmacology, it will be easier for our lives na masabtan si pharmacology if we first master the autonomic nervous system. Pag nasabtan ninyo ang autonomic nervous system, it will be easier for us to study other drugs. Even if ano outside na sila sa ANS, mas dali na nato sila masabtan. How they act or what's their mechanism of action, mas madali if, again, we understand and we master the autonomic nervous system. So, si autonomic nervous system is actually a subclassification under the nervous system. So, we are talking about the nervous system here. So, when you say, ano class, nervous system, duha na siya ka klase. I mean, duha ka division. We have the peripheral nervous system and the central nervous system. When you say central nervous system, it's the brain and the spinal cord. So they control everything sa atuang body. But we will be talking more about the peripheral nervous system. Now, the peripheral nervous system is further divided into two. We have the efferent division and we have the afferent division. Wait, let me set up my tablet first. I need to write sa screen. Where is my pen? Wait lang. Okay, later na lang. I'm looking for my pen. Later na lang tong ulan, appeal na correction. Para mas dali ninyo na siya ma-memorize ang efferent and afferent division, you just use this mnemonic. Same. Okay? Sensory for afferent, motor for efferent. Sensory for afferent, and motor for efferent. Okay? So when you say sensory, lahat ng nerves in the body na ang function is for ano sensory. Like kung nakatouch ka og bugnaw, then your nerves for the senses will recognize that as bugnaw siya. So ano na siya kanang from the tip of your fingers, you have your sensory neurons there. Once you touch something, then naana siya, ma-recognize na niya, and then it will send message to the brain, to the central nervous system, na kana imong gigunitan, bugnaw na siya. Okay? Now, pag init imuhang gigunitan, class, it's the same thing. The sensory neurons in your body will recognize it. It will send message to the brain na mag-ingon siya dito na init ang imuhang gigunitan. Now, your brain will also send signal or message pabalik, but this time it will be on the motor neuron. So, si motor neuron na ang mag-act. So kung init siya, kailangan nimo tanggalon ang imuhang kamot. So from the sensory neurons going to the CNS and then CNS going back, but this time sa motor neuron na siya para mulihok ang imuhang body. So ano na siya, mga types of neurons inside the body. Just use the mnemonics same so that dili mo ma-confuse between the efferent and the afferent division. Kasi E o A lang ang naglahian na sa ilaha. Just, you just remember sensory for afferent and motor for efferent. Okay? Pero class, please take note ha, that the message is very fast. Nga pag-touch nimo sa something, paspas na kayo ang message padulong sa imuhang CNS. Kaya nga naman, kung nagbaktas ang imuhang message class, ang message sa imuhang sensory neurons, nasunog na imuhang skin, wala pa nag-react ang imuhang motor neurons. So definitely dapat paspas ang message sa mga neurons, ana. Okay? So mana siya class nga, if you have something wrong with your neurons, like for diabetic patients, wherein their neurons will be damaged, their nerve cells will be damaged because of the very high sugar na mag-deposit dito sa ilahang mga nerve cells, mga nerve endings nila. The patient will experience neuropathy and then they will not feel anything. So I don't know if you know someone na diabetic na ay neuropathy class, like na magugoy na ilha na natamakan niya ang thumbtacks, tapos wala siya na feel nalubong na din ang thumbtacks sa iyahang tiil, and hangtod na wala siya na infect, wala jud siya kabalungan na ay thumbtacks sa iyahang tiil. So grabe na ang infection pagkahuman. So again, na wala na, matay na ang sensory na mga neurons for that. Nagamanhid? What do you mean na nagamanhid? Is it because of kanang ng long duration nga the same position, or mukalit lang jud og pangmanhid? Natay ano, nataklas ka ng sensory, what do you call that? Medical term is, what do you call that? Wait lang ha. Bigla na lang magmanhid. Na? Nasa dili na siya makafeel. Bigla na lang magmanhid. You have something wrong with your nerves kung ingana. Pero kanaganing magpirmi ka maka-experience o tingling sensation, kanaganing murag ginatusok-tusok ang imuhang kamot. Murag na ay karayom nga ginatusok-tusok imong kamot or imuhang tiil. Pwede na siya because of long na same position, tapos pwede pud na siya na nakay deficiency sa vitamin B. So ang vitamins na kailangan nato for that is vitamin B. So kung ano, kung ingana majeda pag magmanhid kalit, pwede siya na may deficiency ka sa vitamin B. Ingna lang kung kinsa man na siya, magano siya, replenish lang vitamin B complex. Okay? Oo. Ano lang na siya, usahay man good magmanhid na siya kanang long standing or long na time na the same ang posture, kasi ang blood ana wala na circulate og tarong. So para mag-circulate siya tarong, kailangan nimo maggalaw-galaw. Pero kung dili man siya tungod sa ano, long time na the same na position, then again, you just take vitamin B complex para matarong na. Even if sa kanang mga kurog o gamot, kanang panauni mo kay nagkurog ilahang kamot.
Si Ma'am.
Oh, si Ma'am Cherry, di ba yung anak kurog o gamot? Anak ko, di ko masugot Cherry nga. Ikaw, ako ang ano, anesthesiologist. Yeah, there is a spinal cord. Mag-inject, eh, kurog kayo na siyang kamot. You can also take vitamin D complex for that kasi involved gihapon ang nerve cells, ana. And again, B complex man good ang vitamins na needed for proper function of our neurons. Okay? kanang reflex sa tuhod na agyud ta ana kanang imuhang ipalo mo mukalit og sipa imuhang tiil nudge na siya nag-exist gyud na siya na reflex din ha. Okay, now under sa efferent division class, the motor division, this is further divided into two, the autonomic system and the somatic system. And then we will concentrate sa autonomic system class kay naa diri under si parasympathetic and si sympathetic nervous system. But we have the third one, the enteric. But ang ato jun discussion from chapter 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Hangtod chapter 7, we will concentrate with these two. Parasympathetic and sympathetic. Okay? So again, sa nervous system nato, di ba, divided ni sa duha. When you say central nervous system, you're talking about the brain and the spinal cord. And anything outside the CNS is called the peripheral nervous system. Again, anything sa outside sa brain and sa spinal cord, peripheral nervous system ato ang tawag. Now, if we go back to the graph, under sa efferent division, we have two, the autonomic and the somatic. Let's differentiate the two. When you say somatic nervous system, ito yung nervous system natin that is concerned with anything that we can control. Okay? Anything na ginahimo sa ato ang body na pwede nato i-control is under the somatic nervous system. For example, mag-move ka, itaas ni mo imong kamot, you can control that. Na itaas ni mo or ibaba ni mo imong kamot, or even if you blink your eyes, di ba, kung gusto ni mo ipiyong or isiga imong mata, you can control that. The neurons under that is under sa somatic nervous system. So even your respiration is also control. Kung gusto ka mo ginhawa, you do that. Kung gusto, you can do that voluntarily. Kung gusto ni mo pugnan ni mo hang ginhawa, you can also do that voluntarily. So anything na voluntarily you can control is under the somatic nervous system. Now, ang kabaliktaran ana, anything na we cannot control is under the autonomic nervous system. So from the name itself, autonomous. This is independent and we cannot control it consciously. So for example, the pumping of your blood, dili ni mo na siya pwede i-control. Dili ni mo siya pwede nga undang sa unya na sad. Dili ni mo pwede paundangon ng imuhang pag-pump sa heart. Unlike your respiration na you can hold your breath. Okay? So mga cardiac functions nato, syempre the blood flow sa organs, and then your digestion, you cannot control that also. So it is under the autonomic nervous system. So pag magkaon ka, dili ka camel class nga ibutang sa diri sa ilahang unsa tawag ana sa ilaha, ibutang sa nila ang water sa murag pocket sa ilahang asa ba na nila ginabutang. And then, pwede nila gamiton. Diliing ana ang sa atua. Pag nagkaon ka, diretso dyan na siya, digestion. Okay? Mukalit og lihok ang pilok. Actually, it's not the pilok ang mukalit og lihok. It's your, yeah, it's the muscles sa imuhang mata. Even sa imuhang face mo, ano man na, di ba? Naay mukalit og ka ng, mupaspas gani ang iyang contraction and then you can feel it. I guess that's what you are trying to say, Sarah. Na mukalit na siya og kanang lihok-lihok din ha. Yeah, it's muscle contraction. Kapag kaingana, good class. Kung ingana siya class, na mukalit siya og kanang lihok na siya, dira you can feel it. It's muscle contraction. Meaning, ang imuhang muscles, grabe ang iyahang contraction na wala na siya halos nag-relax. We call it muscle twitching. Let me write it on the screen. Wait lang. Muscle twitching. So when you experience muscle twitching class, kung sa mata na siya, meaning ana, na-stress na imong mata, nakapoy na siya, you have to rest. Okay? kapag sa nawong pud na, it's the same thing. It's an indication na you are stressed. That is why your muscles are contracting very fast. Okay? Nagapitik-pitik. Yeah, that's correct, Belly. Nagapitik-pitik siya. It's an indication that you are under stress, so you need to relax. Labi na sa imuhang mata class, like, if tibok adlaw ka nag-K-drama, grabe, wadyo ka natulog, kaya humanun dyan mo ang isa ka series, your eyes will be, tired, and then, pwede siya na mag-experience of muscle twitching. Sana all kamen. No, it's not because nakakaon ka kinaunan sa ilaga, no? Ano lang gina siya? It's an indication na stress ka. So, pahuway sad. It's your body telling you that it is already tired. Okay? So, you listen to your body class. Actually, our body gives us message na like kung gikapoy na siya, ana, naghahatag og message ato ang body. So, isa na din ha ang muscle twitching sa mata or sa nawong. Even if ka na ganing nag-ano ka, nang huyab ka, ano sa Tagalog ang nang huyab class? Nang huyab ka class.
Maghikab, ma'am.
Maghikab ka. That's also your body telling you na you need to sleep kasi it's already tired. So you have to listen to your body.
Ay, hello. Hiling na ko mag-hikab na ko taon-taon.
Wala laing tambal sa katulogon, matulog. Pagkatulogon na, matulog na, ha? Dili-pilito na ang sarili. Like, magtanaw o palabas, piliton yun hangtod sa kaadlawon.
Ma'am, unsay ano, ma'am, kanang scientific explanation pag may makita ka ng way-up, mang-way-up pud ka?
Ah, okay. that is your body sending signals called pheromones. Okay. So, naana siya, ano, contagious, tinood na siya. If, ano, ang isa naghikab niya na ay isa din ha sa imuhang tapad, maghikab po na siya. Kasi, ang atong body class, nag-send po siya o pheromones ang tawag na. It's a chemical substance na masend siya, mabalhin siya sa pikas, mauna nga, manghuyabsad siya. So naay ano, naay scientific explanation ana, naay chemical na gina-release ato ang body. Even sa ato girls, kay girls man tatanan diri no. Napansin ninyo kung duguon ka kay hala duguon na mo tanan pagkahuman kay ana pud na siya basta ang isa ka lawas sa girl is nag-menstruation siya, mag-release pud na siya og pheromones and then makuha po na siya sa uban, nakauban ni Mudra sa ilahang body. And then, mo na siya nga magsunod-sunod na dayon mo nga nag-menstruation. Oo, ano na siya? Nagasabay-sabay na siya. Hurag na yung wifi pa-connect. O, ano, ganun na siya, class. Labi na pag you live in the same house, magtugma na ang date sa inyong menstruation because of the pheromones.
Ako mama, menstruation tapos pagkasunod ako na.
Yeah. So ana gid na siya musunod gud na pag naanay mauna, nag-send na ang pheromones ang iyahang body, musunod na gid na ang kauban. Contagious gid na siya. Let me go back sa Bell's palsy. Bell's palsy is another condition, dili na siya sa muscle twitching lang. Kay si muscle twitching, grabe ang contraction. Si Bell's palsy manggood is murag paralysis of the muscles sa face. So kung nakakita mo o someone nga nag Bell's palsy, di ba mo bitay man na ang one half sa iyahang face. So yeah, one part only mo bitay siya. Wala na siya nag-contract. So pag mungisi na sila, this side will smile but the other side will not. Kasi wala na siya nag-contract. Din ha. So, daghan og reason nga nung naga-Bell's palsy. So, naay mga underlying na mga causes, naay sa nervous system na problema. Pero, ang uban nga kanang dili gani makita ang cause sa Bell's palsy nila, it's because of stress also. So, I know someone nga nag-Bell's palsy siya kasi that was the time na bago siyang panganak sa ilahang bunso. Tapos, nadakpan niya iyahang husband na naay kabit. Okay? So tapos ang kabit sa iyahang husband kay ang iyahang pinsan. Sa iyahang pinsan, sa babae mismo na gipa murag teleserye lang no ang peg na iyahang gipa puyo sa ilahang balay. Ana god na gipa iskwela.
Alaw murag ka sa radyo.
Murag sa radyo na pero na hitabogin na siya sa true to that, is a true to life story. And then sa grabe ang stress sa girl kay nag Bell's palsy siya. Pero okay na siya karon, okay na ang iyahang face karon. Pero pag niagi mang gud kag Bell's palsy, bisan pa og naayon na ka, makita gihapon na ay mabilin nga parts sa imong nawong na mabalan gihapon nga murag dili siya totally
inaoperahan yan siya, ma'am.
No, wala siya gioperahan pero nagaano siya PT, physical therapy siya para magbalik og ano contract ang mga muscles sa yahang face. Ah, si Angelina Jolie. Pwede po siya acupuncture. Actually, the people nowadays are shifting to oriental medicine. That is also good. Actually, ako, ganahan ko ang oriental medicine. I want to try acupuncture, but I cannot get myself to try chiropractor. Chiropractor, dili na ako kaya basta magbali. Di ba, ginapalutok-lutok ang mga, ano, ang mga bones. Pero actually, okay, pag nag-chiro, nagpa-chiro ka kayo, mutaas daw kagamay. Mutaas kagamay. Basta maabot akong height of 5. Pero para na sa mga na-escolyo, ana, ang acupuncture kay ka ng mga needle. Ang tawag ana sa ilaha kay oriental medicine. Maudyan na siya ang way sa kaning mga Asian countries. Kaya lang ang Philippines man good, since nasakop manguta, when we look at the history sa Philippines, nasakop manguta sa America, tapos sa tawag na sa Spain. So ang atuang medicine diri is more of Western. Western medicine, ta kanang mo inom gudog tambal, mga synthetic nga tambal, that's a Western practice. Tumaw na siya ang sa Philippines. Pero when you go to China, to Korea, ang rampant yun dito is oriental medicine. Actually, ganahan ko ana jud ang oriental medicine. Yeah, kung wala siya naghikab ang imuhang katapad, wala siya nakadetect sa pheromones. That's true. Isa pa. Yeah, magkasunod jud mo ana sa inyuhang mama. Kung ginadugo pa inyuhang mama ha, kay nagainyuhang pheromones. By the way, class, ang pheromones, that's the same chemical that ants release. Kana ganing, di ba, ang mga ants, nagalinya na sila. Wala, di ba, dili makakita ang ants, blind man ang mga, amigas. They are blind. So, ganong mag-isa kalinya na sila, no? Pagputlo na nimo, di ba, dili na sila kabalo asa sila padulong mga saag na sila kasi na-erase na ang pheromones nga gibilin sa ilahang gisundan. Oh, that's the same thing kun sa ato, pheromones pud na ang hinungdan nganong kana ng regla ang hikab ma-pass on. Too much radiation, what do you mean ang Bell's palsy? Pwede siya pero most likely sa stress. Dili man jud permanent condition ang Bell's palsy, ha, pwede siya mag-therapy. Hindi na ito mag-asaw. Sa mukha. Yeah. Ang ventosa is oriental medicine, gihapon na siya. Anong butang drio, mamurakag mahimog pepperoni, pizza, ay bilog-bilog sa likod. Mga panuhot na siya, di ba? Yeah, ang baso mo na mahimok kag murag pepperoni kay ang baso man pilit man na dito sa imong likod ni ilahang birahon mo na magpula. Ayan. So, yeah, baso na siya. Effective mapud na sa mga panuhot. Pero pag Western, manggo di mong practice class, di manggo ka mutuo, ana. Pero ako personally, mutuo ko both Western o Oriental na practice. Eh, okay ra ko kung mainom og tambal. Okay ra pong ko mag-oriental medicine. I really want to try that. Ang kanang mga herbs, oriental man na siya nga practice. Mga herbs, mga Chinese man na. Lahi po ng cerebral palsy. Okay. Sa cerebral palsy mang good kay sa ano gid na siya? Sa brain. Okay? Sa ulo gid na siya from the term cerebral, ulo. Oh, mga baso-baso. I really want to try that. Pero nagatigom pa ko, ano, kanang lakas ng loob kong magpa-chiro. Si Cherry, nagpa-chiro siya kay, rag na atay scoliosis, mild lang si Cherry nga scoliosis niya. Nagasakit ang iyahang likod. I guess, nag-try siya og chiro. Kanang mga, birabirahon ang imuhang mga bukog-bukog, tabang, nahadlok, manggug ko kay motingog. So, magana sa kawag tigom sa kog lakas ng loob. Pero kung maingon kag mapa-acupuncture ko karon, sugot ko anang acupuncture bisan pag needle na ipang tusok-tusok. Yeah, that's okay. Anyway, balik ta dito sa ano. Hihilot to. Yeah, actually nagapangita ko og someone nga kabalo jud mag-acupuncture. I want na kung magpa-acupuncture man ko. Gusto ko kanang ano jud iskwilahan gid na niya kay basig pag mamali man gud ang tusok sa needle ana basig may maigo nga ugat ba maparalyze pa kagwa sa time. So gusto ko kanang gigraduitan gid na niya. Naman jud good kurso ana dilang uso sa Pilipinas.
Nya ma'am naunsa si Ma'am Cherry tong nagpa-chiro siya.
Okay na siya. Nawala pud ang iyang niya nagpa-acupuncture pud to siya mo to nawala na iyang mga allergy. Daghan ba kay nag-allergy si Cherry. Ano ba na si Cherry kanang pag stress kaayo si Cherry na okay na siya, okay pag muday down na iyang stress kanang wala na gani siya himuon dili naman siya ma-stress ana no pag wala na ang stress niya kay magkagid naman siya dayon allergy sa English sa Bisaya kagid naman na siya dayon after the chiro and the acupuncture wala naman na ano wala na na iyang mga kagid physical therapy, it's not the same thing. Kasi, kanang PT, di ba naatay course ano sa school, it's not the same. Kan, ang PT mang good kay ginaano na nila, di ba, gina-exercise nila ang muscles para sa kanang mga na-paralyze, kanang na-stroke, ana. That's a different practice. Pero pamingon kag oriental medicine, acupuncture, tusok-tusok sa needle tapos ang chiro mangod it's not the same with the physical therapy ang chiro kag birahon gid baya like diri sa imong liog kay butangan og towel nya birahon pataas mahadlok ko sigaputulok ang ulo mahadlok wala pa ko yung lakas ng loob pero I saw my brothers ako mga akong duha ka manghod nakatry na sila magpa chiro so pag ano pag higda pa lang sa akong manghod na isa kay nakita dito dili day siya pantay ang iyahang tiil so layo ra ba layo ra ang isa kay diri ang isa kay murag atras gamay ang iyang tiil gibira sa doktor ang iyang isa ka tiil after the session kay natupong na yung tiil oh kanang mga Korean medicine appeal na din ha mga chiro acupuncture napoy traditional herbal medicine naghana sila basta mga oriental medicine. So basta western ang doctor dili na sila mo tuuan kasi more on tambal-tambal gid na ang ano I mean drugs pag western medicine okay so I hope you can now differentiate somatic and autonomic somatic is voluntary while autonomic is involuntary okay but both systems actually have also afferent neurons or mga afferent inputs. So, mo na siya ang mag-provide og message sa mga internal organs nato, kana mga messages inside and even outside like sa environment. Pwede pud na siya mag-send og signal dito sa atong mga organs and ang mag-take og action jud ana class kay ang motor neurons. But then again, somatic and autonomic nervous systems, both of them have motor neurons and meron din silang sensory neurons. Now, paano? Kagay na pa ko sigigingon og mga messages, signals. Kanang message or signals inside our body, they are being carried by chemicals. So, chemicals ang nagdalaan na para mag-travel ang message from nerve cells, padulong sa another nerve cells, even padulong sa ato ang central nervous system, and then going back from the central nervous system, going back to the other parts of the body na ay signal na ay message nga nag-travel, it is carried by chemicals. So, depende na siya sa chemicals na responsible for that specific function. So, natay tulo, we call them neurotransmitters. If they originate from the glands, then we call them hormones, and then we also have local mediators. Okay? Questions so far? Wala. So let's talk about the anatomy of the autonomic nervous system. Balik ta sa inyuhang anatomy. Is it teacher ninyo sa anatomy gani?
Urbinuya.
See? Sige siya?
Sir Binuya, ma'am.
Ay, Sir Binuya din yung teacher? Okay. Siya po din yung lab? Okay. Sige. So let's talk again about the anatomy of the autonomic nervous system. Mag-focus ta sa ANS. Okay? Now, diba, remember, si ANS is divided into three, sympathetic, parasympathetic, and enteric. Pag sinabing enteric, that is concerned with the gastrointestinal tract. But we will concentrate with the sympa and the parasympa. Now, si sympa and parasympa, ang origin dyan sa ilahang message is from the spinal cord. Kaya lang ang difference nila, si sympa, I call it sympa ha para mapadali. Si sympa, ang iyahang outflow sa message is from the thoracolumbar part of the spinal cord. While si parasympathetic, si parasympa, it originates from the craniosacral. Specifically, sa cranio, it's the 3rd, 7th, 9th, and 10th nerve of the cranial part. And for the sacral na part, it's from the 3rd and the 4th nerve sa sacral na region. So, ano ni siya class? If this is the spinal cord, dyan na ang mag-drawing dyan ta. So, this one here is the cranial na part or cranial na part. And ang tumoy ana, we call it the sacral. Okay, this is the cranial here. Diridapit sa adong neck na part padulong going to the head, we call it cranial. And then, after that, sa may abaga na dapit, we call it thoracic region. Thoracic. So, this is the thoracic na part here. And ang diri before the sacral is the lumbar. That's how we divide our spinal cord. Now, for the sympathetic, ang message or ang outflow is from here, from this part of the spinal cord, the thoracolumbar, or the thoracic and the lumbar part. Now, for the parasympathetic, nag-originate siya dire sa cranial and here, sa sacral, sa last na portion. Okay? Now, another thing that you have to know about the sympa and the parasympa is duha lang ni sila ka nerve cells. Naalang dun sila ay tag-as na mga nerve endings nga makaabot sila sa different parts or different organs of the body. So, duha lang ka, again, duha lang ka nerve cells or duha lang ka neuron. So, let us draw it again. Okay. So for example, you have part here sa parasympa. Naana siya isa ka neuron that originates here. So diri siya gikan. Hindi ko kabalo mag-drawing og neuron, so anaon na lang nato siya. Okay? So I'm talking about parasympa ha kay cranium maning part. So, duha kabuk iyahang neuron class. The first neuron is called preganglionic neuron. Again, the first neuron for the both of them, sympa and parasympa, is called preganglionic neuron. So, let's draw for the first, the sympathetic nervous system. Dirita sa thoracic part, dapat mag-draw. So, ingani siya. Now, both of the preganglionic neuron of the simpa and the parasimpa are located near the spinal cord. Now, asa sila nag-differ sa length sa neuron? Kaya kung napansin ninyo, for the parasimpa, right here, parasimpa. Parasimpa. This one is simpa. Okay, for the parasimpa, the preganglionic neuron or the first na neuron is longer, while for the simpa, it's shorter. Okay? Again, shorter si simpa. Now, location of the ganglion. Do you know what's the meaning of a ganglion? Are you familiar? Okay. Based sa inyong anatomy class, unsay meaning sa ganglion or sa ganglia? Or is it the first time na encounter ninyo na nga word? First time? Okay. So, ano siya class? The ganglion is here, this one. It's the region or the junction between two neurons. Kung sa layman's term pa, kung bisayaon pa nato siya class, space din ha, before mag-connect ang isa ka neuron sa another neuron, we call it ganglion. So, pagdaghan, pag plural siya, we call it ganglia. So, kay ani ni siya class, since sa parasympathetic, the preganglionic neuron is longer, therefore, ang location sa iyahang ganglion is far from the spinal cord. And since sa sympathetic nervous system, shorter ang iyahang preganglionic neuron, ang iyahang ganglion is near sa spinal cord. Okay? So, muna siyang gitawag og preganglionic neuron kay before siya sa ganglion na neuron. Therefore, class, ang ikaduhangan neuron is called postganglionic neuron. Ang ikaduha kay ang tawag post kay pagkahuman man siya sa ganglion. Okay? So, baliktad po na sila. Since sa parasympathetic longer na iyahang preganglionic neuron, automatic class iyahang post kay shorter. Tapos for the sympathetic, longer pod ang iyahang postganglionic neuron. By the way, SNS is sympathetic nervous system and PNS is parasympathetic nervous system. Now, naay mga chemical messengers sa ganglion, sa mga ending sa nerves, naana sila yung mga neurotransmitters or mga chemical messengers. So, ang inyuhang tandaan for both simpa and parasympathetic nervous system, ang chemical messenger sa ganglion. So, I'm talking about sa ganglion. It's the same thing. It's acetylcholine. Mauna siya ang, again, neurotransmitter nga makita sa ganglion for both SNS and PNS. Now, they differ, kani silang duha, they differ dito sa neurotransmitter na makita sa postganglionic neuron, kaning pagkahuman din hi. Okay? Na taas nila mga nerve endings class, daghan sila nerve endings, ang isa kay nasa heart padulong, ang isa kay nasa kidney, ang isa nasa liver. It's the same thing with the parasympathetic na ay maabot sa heart, na ay maabot sa liver, and so on. Now, ang chemical messengers sa end, sa postganglionic neuron, kay sa parasympathetic, it's still acetylcholine, but this time for the sympathetic, it's norepinephrine. So, these are board exam questions. Kanita na ako ang gibutang diri sa table. Kasi when you read the book, especially the Katzong, it's a bit complicated. Kaya i-table na lang nato siya para mas dali. Kani sila tanan akong gibutang sa table. They are board exam questions. You need to know that the chemical messenger or the neurotransmitter in the ganglion is acetylcholine for both simpa and parasimpa. Okay? We abbreviate acetylcholine as ACH. H. And then for the postganglionic, ang ikaduhang neuron, ang end ana niya, ang chemical messenger or ang neurotransmitter is sa parasimpa, it's acetylcholine, and sa simpa, it's norepinephrine. So mga neurotransmitters nato na sila, they are chemical messengers. Okay? Board exam question pud na class, kung pila ka buok ang neurons involved, you only have 2. Okay? So duha kada portion sa simpa o para simpa. Pero class, kaning simpa man good, this is the major neurotransmitter. Pero naay uban nga nerve endings si simpa nga ang iyahang iyahang neurotransmitter kay acetylcholine. Pero limited lang na siya. That will explain some of the effects of the sympathetic nervous system. Kanang naa siya'y nerve ending nga nag-end sa acetylcholine. But the major part here is the norepinephrine. Questions so far sa anatomy of our autonomic nervous system. They are all automatic ha, kasi autonomic maningan nervous system, ang SNS o PNS. Dili nato ni siya mapugngan. Dili nato mapugngan nga ma-release si norepinephrine. Di po nato na mapugngan nga ma-release si acetylcholine. Okay? Wala questions? O natulog na mo din ha? Nagsugod na mo pang huyab? Kasi kawan ako kay story, Andrea. Wala, sure na. Okay. Sige. Let me delete this first. Okay? Now, I hope that is clear. Mauni tong question ni Sarah. I remembered Sarah asking what is anticholinergic and cholinergic. Kapag ka ang neurotransmitter involved is acetylcholine, we call it cholinergic. Pag ang drug kay ginagaya niya or ginamimic, when you say mimic, di ba, ginagaya niya. Pag ang drug kay ang iyang ginagaya kay ang effect ni acetylcholine, we call it cholinergic. But if it is the opposite of the effect of acetylcholine, then we call it anticholinergic. Again, it's anticholinergic. Now, for norepinephrine, other name manggod sa norepinephrine kay noradrenaline. Noradrenaline. Kasi kapamilya ni sila ni epinephrine. Other name ni epinephrine kay adrenaline. Mo ni siya ang kanang gina-release when you have adrenaline rush. Kana ganing like naisunog, di ba? Naalsa na ni mo inyong ref, sa kabugat sa ref, naalsa na ninyo. It's because...
Unexpected, ma'am.
It's because of adrenaline. Adrenaline is the other name for epinephrine. And for noradrenaline, that's norepinephrine. So kapag kanipod, ang drug kay ginagaya niya or ginamimic niya ang effect ni norepinephrine, we call it adrenergic. Okay? Adrenergic, pero this time we will use agonist. Adrenergic agonist. But if it blocks the effect of the norepinephrine, we call it adrenergic antagonist. So I hope nasabtan ninyo ni. Pag kabalo na mo kung ang drug cholinergic, anticholinergic, adrenergic agonist, og antagonist, it will be easier for you to study other drugs. Okay? Questions? Magkalimot ha, pag naisunog class, nag-adrenaline rush ka, meaning ang imuhang adrenal medulla sa may kidney na part, nagsigig produce og epinephrine. And mauna na siya ang time nga, you are very excited, your cells are very excited, including your muscle cells, your CNS, and mauna lagi nga, maalsa na ninyo inyong ref. Okay. Because of the epinephrine. It's not because of the norepinephrine ha, it's because of epinephrine. They are different because norepinephrine is a neurotransmitter. This is produced by the neurons. And epinephrine is a hormone because this is more of a hormone because it is produced by the adrenal medulla. So, si adrenal medulla is an organ located right above the kidney. So this, if this is your kidney, right above your kidney, you can see the adrenal medulla, and that's the one that releases the adrenaline or the epinephrine. So more, it's more of a gland. Kaya epinephrine is considered as a hormone. Pero parehas lang na sila effect ni norepinephrine class. Naglahi lang na sila ug origin. Okay? So we are almost done. We have chemical messengers, di ba, ingon ko sa body. So let's differentiate the three though. I think I have started differentiating this. When you say hormones class, they are produced by the cells sa ating mga mga endocrine cells sa mga endocrine glands na to. Most of them kay sa glands na siya na produce. So i-release na siya dito sa bloodstream. And then they will travel all throughout the body. And then when they reach the target cells sa mga organs na to, mag-cause sila og effect. Those are hormones. Ang origin lang dyan nila, gikan sila sa glands, sa endocrine cells, sa ato ang mga glands. Now, pag moingon ka og neurotransmitters, they are also chemical messengers. Released in our blood, they travel also all throughout our body, and then once they reach the target cells, they will take their action. However, their origin is, when you say neurotransmitters, they are released, they are produced and released by the neurons or the nerve cells. Mo nang gitawag sila neurotransmitters. Now, we have the third chemical messengers. They are called local mediators. Ginatawag sila local mediators because they are also produced by our cells in the body, but after the release, right there and then they will take action. They will not, unlike the two, unlike neurotransmitters and hormones, local mediators do not travel all throughout the body for them to take their action. Si local mediators, kung asa sila na release, dito po sila mag-take og action. Okay, so like histamine, if they are released in the bronchioles, then you will experience bronchoconstriction, maglisod ka og ginhawa. Okay, and prostaglandins, if they are released kay nakay, like nasamad ka, so kung asa ka nasamad, dito nagproduce si prostaglandin, dito po na siya mag-take og action, and dito lang po ang mag-inflame. Lisod po kung nasamad ka sa kamot, ang tiil ni mo ang nag-inflame. So, dili siya ingana. That is why we call it local mediators. Kung asa sila na-release, dito sila mag-take og action. Okay? So, we can call them also autacoids. Okay? That is why they have separate chapter for this histamine and prostaglandin. They are called autacoids. Tama na siya, Jai. Local mediators are also called autacoids. They have different na chapter for this because lahi sila og action ni neurotransmitter ug ni hormones. So, that's it for the anatomy of the autonomic nervous system. Okay? So, tomorrow, dili pa ako mag-quiz ani tomorrow. Next week pa ta mag-quiz anil. Ano dyan na siya pirmiha? 1 week na preparation before ang quiz. Pero tomorrow, I will be starting my lesson sa chapter 4. It's about cholinergic agonists. So, mga cholinergics atong istoryahan. Ugma, those are the drugs that mimic the actions of acetylcholine. So, we will concentrate sa parasympathetic nervous system tomorrow. Again, you can read in advance if you like. And then, the quiz for the chapter 3 point, sa chapter 3 di is next week. Monday. Now, I'm giving you an assignment. This is a case study. So, dili jud ko musugot nga pare-parehas mo og answer ani, basigi kopya lang sa classmate. Klaro kaayo tanan words gi-copy. Kulang na lang pangalan. So, since this is a case study, this is based on your understanding and research. Okay? So, sa case study, we have here a teenage boy is seen at the office of a dental surgeon for extraction of an impacted wisdom tooth. I hope na sabtan man ano. He is so nervous that the dentist decides to administer a sedative to calm the boy. After intravenous administration of the sedative the dentist gave it was promethazine. That's the name of the sedative. The boy relaxes and the extraction is accomplished with no complications. However, when the boy stands up from the dental chair, he turns very pale and faints. Lying on the floor, he rapidly regains consciousness but has a rapid heart rate of 120 beats per minute. Take note that the normal heart rate is 60 to 100 beats per minute. So the boy is experiencing tachycardia, more than 100. And a blood pressure of only 110 over 70 millimeters of mercury. Okay? When he sits up, his heart rate increases to 140 beats per minute and his pressure drops to 80 over 40 millimeters of mercury. And he complains faintness. Okay? He is helped in the reception area where he rests for 30 minutes. At the end of this time, the boy is able to sit up without symptoms, and after an additional 15 minutes, he is able to stand without difficulty. What autonomic effects might promethazine have that would explain the patient's signs and symptoms? And then you have to answer also this question, why did his heart rate increase when his blood pressure dropped? I want you to write your answer on a piece of paper and send nyo lang doon sa ipoprovide ko na portion or part sa Schoology. You have to understand the case and syempre you have to read because I believe you are not familiar with promethazine. So you have to research and read about promethazine and nganong ingani ang iyahang effect and nganong nag-drop ang iyahang blood pressure pero nag-experience siya og tachycardia. So that will be your assignment. I think I'm giving you 1 week also for this kasi medyo mahaba-haba na readings. So ato ang answeran ni sa Monday. Singlon tamuan ni sa Monday. Okay? Questions? Questions?